In this video, we'll install the brake booster and brake master cylinder. Compare your donor's brake master cylinder to the master cylinders on screen. If the ports on top of your master cylinder are spaced apart, yours is an early model. If the ports are close together, yours is a late model. Late model donor cars included an aluminum spacer on the brake booster. Install this spacer at this time. Early model systems do not have this spacer. Slide the brake booster into the front of the pedal box with the master cylinder upright. Use the donor brake booster nuts to attach the booster to your Goblin. Slide the pedal push rod onto the brake pedal. Fasten it with the original foam pad and nut. When you go to connect the rear brake line, you might have to adjust the shape. Carefully bend the line until the flare and brake line are aligned with the master cylinder port. When everything is aligned properly, the brake tube nut will easily thread into the port. Tighten the brake tube nut. At first it will feel soft as the flare is crushed into the port. Tighten until it feels solid. Use a coated clamp to fasten the lines to the chassis. If you are building an automatic Goblin, use a 1/4-inch clamp from the K22 baggie. Otherwise, use a 3/8 clamp from the K22D baggie.